Please like and subscribe to channel if you enjoy the video. My story. How my ex fooled me, my family, and her family. My ex-husband and I had been dating for almost 6 years and married for 4 years before splitting up. We had known one other for 5 years before to it, but had not spent much time together until we began dating. I established a company shortly after marrying my wife, although she was still in college at the time. For the first 3 years, she was enrolled full-time in school, and we utilized every penny I earned to pay for her educational expenditures. We never took out a single loan, nor had any help from family. She also took part-time waitress jobs here and there to supplement her income. She ended up graduating summa cum laude and immediately began working with me full-time, rather than seeking a job that would have required her degree. My company had grown to 6-8 employees by the time she graduated. Exactly 1 year had passed between the time she graduated and the day our divorce was finally completed. I didn't have any reservations about her. I had complete faith in her. At the beginning of January, she was sleeping, and I was putting our phones on the chargers before going to sleep. When I disconnected hers, a Snapchat message on her lock screen appeared from a person I didn't recognize. I didn't know how Snapchat worked at the time. I quickly deleted the message. I took it out of the box and began reading it. It seems that she had known the man since high school and that he was aware that she was married. During the chats, she made disparaging remarks about me, and they made arrangements to go out and grab drinks on many occasions. My attention was drawn to another conversation log between her and her high school lover, which I quickly deleted. They had a similar chat yet again, and they made arrangements for other occasions throughout the course of our whole relationship. What a feeling of being crushed. I roused her from her sleep and inquired as to what was going on. She categorically denied everything. We fought for the following 3 weeks, and on the third weekend, when she was supposed to be out with a friend, she texted me, saying, "I'll be home in 30 minutes. She didn't show up at all. The second weekend she stayed with her mom, which was also a lie. I began searching through our phone records and discovered a lot of weird phone numbers, but I couldn't figure out who was calling them or what they were for. I later found out she had a texting app, WhatsApp. It was afternoon when she finally called me and said, "I'm on my way home. I'll speak to you when I get there." When she returned home, she revealed that she had fallen asleep at the residence of a man she had been seeing. She said that the affair had just recently occurred and that they had only seen one other a few of times before vowing never to see each other again. They never had relations, they simply kissed. They met in the supermarket and exchanged contact information. She advised me to put my faith in her and forget about it. For the following several weeks, whenever I questioned her, she would invariably respond in a defensive manner. She made me feel like a bad person for interrogating her in the middle of the night. At the beginning of February, I'd had enough and urged her to get out of my life. I then filed for divorce with the court. From February until June, we continued to collaborate on projects. I was terribly depressed throughout the months of February and March. To be really honest, I'm astonished I'm still alive. Regardless, I insisted on her being in the house for a little longer. Despite my best efforts, I couldn't bring myself to believe it. It was particularly difficult for me to accept since she didn't want me to believe it. Our divorce was completed in the middle of May. Throughout the whole ordeal, she would come over and spend a few nights with us, where she would act as if nothing had occurred. When I first informed her I intended to file for divorce, I explained that I just wanted to have a plan in place in case things changed and that I would not follow through if things changed. I was interrogated and made to feel like a lunatic for the whole 5 months she had me. Her response was to tell me she would never do such a thing to me again, that she would never do anything again, and that if I did go forward with it, I would always regret it. She even signed a postnuptial agreement stating that if she was discovered cheating again, she would only get 10% of the proceeds. We weren't wealthy, but we were 10 times better off than the majority of people our age. She was well aware of my severe anxiousness and took advantage of it. I eventually decided to go through with it because there was just too much craziness. Let's fast forward to the beginning of June. On a Monday, I received a phone call from an unknown caller. Initially, there was a heated debate over the phone. He then continued to tell me that he had met my ex-wife on Tinder back in November, and that they had instantly clicked and were boyfriend and girlfriend. She informed him that she was in an abusive marriage, that her ex-husband had beaten her and taken her to the hospital on several occasions, and that she had divorced him a year earlier. According to her, I was the subject of a restraining order. She also said that she and her brother had formed a business together years ago, but that her brother had passed away a few months previously and that she was now in charge of the firm. It's strange that he wasn't invited to the funeral. She has never had a sibling of her own. In fact, I showed him visual evidence of everything, including the messages she had sent me the previous Friday night, inviting me to hang out and drink with her. He instantly recognized that everything was a lie and that he had been duped. As a matter of fact, she phoned me when I was on the phone with him, and I answered her call using a three-way conversation so that he could hear her. He then went on to say, "I can't believe I squandered 6 months of my life. My penny reserves were depleted in no time. I squandered 6 years of my life, spent more than $40,000 on college tuition, contributed a large sum of money to our divorce settlement, purchased more than 12 acres on which to construct our dream home, and sacrificed all I had to her. I was in the frame of mind that children were on the way and that this would be our way of life for the foreseeable future. When I got off the phone, I had around 100 mental boxes ticked and questions addressed. I felt much better about my choices and was certain that I wasn't going insane. I immediately fired her from the company and told her to go find work elsewhere. It's been around 8 weeks after we officially ended our relationship. Does all of this imply that things have become easier? No way in hell. There are a lot of concerns and a lot of people are asking how things could have gotten so out of hand. Having evidence of 4+ years of infidelity with 4 separate men doesn't make it any easier to get away with it. I believe it makes you feel even more uncomfortable and crazy than you already do. I've never had a genuine dislike for somebody, but for the last 6 weeks, the mere idea of her has caused me to feel a continual burning rage. For the first 6 months, I believe I was in such shock that I was more astonished and unhappy than anything else, and I didn't show any emotion. I've been really upset and depressed over the previous 6-8 weeks, and I blame myself. We had everything going for us, and she absolutely squandered it all by dumping everything on us. The fact that she came to me at some time and said, "Hey, I don't believe this is going to work out blah blah," didn't bother me in the least. The fact that she supported and promoted our relationship for 6 years while she was out cheating the whole time was a turning point for me. Even after she was discovered, she continued to insist that we could work it out. I'm aware that everyone claims that our relationship was different. There have been a slew of common acquaintances who have reached out to me to tell me how amazed they were and how it shook their world. We have a fantastic communication system and a connection that was completely honest and without BS. I've received the most frequent compliment, "Y'all truly did appear like best friends," which I really agree with. My family and her family were both completely taken aback and couldn't believe what had happened. We used to be able to sit at home and talk with no one else but each other. It was common for us to laugh and make light of our mutual friends who were continually cheating or involved in relationship after relationship, and we'd exclaim, "How could they do that?" In the end, I was married to someone who was 10 times worse than everyone else we had made fun of.